8 years after a Malaysia Airlines plane was shot out of the sky, killing everyone on board, including 38 Australians, finally, the truth. Three Russian-backed fugitives have been found guilty in a Dutch court, bringing a semblance of justice to the victims' families who have waited so long.
For Australian relatives in the Dutch courtroom, the moment they've waited 8 years for.
De rechtbank is van oordeel.
The court imposes a lifelong prison sentence to Gherkin, Dubinsky and Kotchenko.
There is a measure of relief in that now the truth has been told to a world audience and that the world knows what happened.
Matthew Horder was there from the Sunshine Coast. He lost his parents, Susan and Howard.
To have, you know, a court at a high level confirmed that this is what happened and that, you know, those people were deliberately murdered by those three defendants is very important for the families.
Two former Russian intelligence officers and a Ukrainian separatist commander in the Donetsk region found guilty of 298 counts of murder and causing the crash of MH17. The fourth Russian man was acquitted. Citing video evidence and wiretaps, the judges found it was beyond doubt the flight was shot down by a Buk missile.
Do you feel like you got justice today?
There's some justice, I guess, in confirming those facts and the truth.
John and Marin O'Brien are from Old Toon Gabby. Their son Jack was 25 when he was killed.
I also feel sad. Because, you know, for all of us it doesn't change anything, so it's a measure of justice, but it would be complete justice if our family members were restored to us.
That someone, that these people could decide to down a civilian aircraft.
Sorry.
Hang on, just take a with children on it, it's beyond words. A bit tired, sorry.
Vanaf een landbouwveld.
The court is aware that imposing these sentences cannot take away the pain and suffering, but does hope, now that clarity has been provided about who is to blame.
So three of the four defendants found guilty of the murders of 298 people aboard flight MH17. But the court also went into forensic detail, linking their actions to the Russian Federation. The missile was supplied by Russia and fired from Russian-held territory. The spokesperson for the Russian Foreign Ministry saying they will study the decision.
It remains a source of grief and it remains a source of anger for the families that Russia still to this time has not accepted any responsibility for what they've done.
We call upon Russia to hand over for justice the people who are involved in this and who've been found to be guilty in absentia.
Adding to their pain, the war that cost their loved ones' lives has seen thousands more killed in the years since.
Putin, stop this senseless violence. We do not need it, and Ukraine has had enough.
In Amsterdam, Brett McLeod, Nine News.
Europe correspondent Brett McLeod is in Amsterdam for us, where the judgment was handed down. So, Brett, will those convicted ever be held to account?
Well, the three men found guilty, Georgie, are believed to be either in the Russian Federation or fighting with Russian forces in occupied Ukraine. So they're not going to be extradited anytime soon. And there are still missing pieces in the puzzle, from those who actually fired the missile to whoever in the Kremlin gave the orders for it to be distributed to that part of the battlefront in 2014. So there may not be any justice there happening soon, but for the families leaving Amsterdam today, they will know that the world is fully aware of the verified facts in this case. Georgie.
Thank you, Brett McLeod.